After a disaster strikes, what's it like being a politician? To find out, I asked former Minister of Defense, Bill Graham. After the 2004 tsunami, he's put in charge, while the Prime Minister and the Minister of Foreign Affairs are out of the country on vacation. This is his story of responding to one of the biggest humanitarian disasters in recent history.
I was on holidays in Montebello with my family, and I got a phone call saying that there'd been this incredible disaster of the tsunami, and to turn on the television and watch it because we had to be figuring out what the Canadian government response would be. As a sort of an idea of the fog of war, if you like, our original response, as you'll recall, was fairly modest, was $4 million.
DART is made up of about 200 soldiers who can be quickly dispatched across the globe to help out when a disaster strikes. After the tsunami hit, Bill Graham's government was criticized for taking too long to send the DART.
The tsunami hit 8 days ago, however. Why has it taken so long?
The trouble with the DART, in a way, is from a bureaucratic point of view, is it's a military instrument, but when you send it abroad, you have to get seated to be willing to pay for it. And usually one department doesn't want to pay for the deployment of another department's assets. You have to sort of get the prime minister to act as a bit of an intermediary to say, well, look, yeah, we're going to use that instrument, so find the money in the budget to be able to do it. The other problem with the DART, of course, was, and I'll say it's a problem, because it was an asset, but because it's military, and it was going into an area of concern, we insisted that the military be armed appropriately to be able to secure the circumference and the perimeter of the DART. And the Sri Lankan government was very hesitant to allow somebody else's armed soldiers on their territory. I mean, we had our officials reporting to us from foreign affairs, from defense. There were satellite images coming in. There were other foreign governments informing us of what had happened. I'd say there's a collection of sources of information. Some are from other governments, some are from your own news. The TV provides you with the instantaneous visual effects.
Right.
But TV itself can be quite misleading because it can show you an isolated incident in a film. You may recall that here in Toronto, at the time of the G20, there was a car on fire in Toronto, and people in Vancouver thought the whole of the city of Toronto was on fire. And so TV can both be illuminating and misleading. While the individual Canadians who are generous often want to give clothing or provide goods or something and put together a container and send it over, usually this is a problem because the container has to be taken, it has to be dealt with, it has to be distributed. I mean, frankly, the local community would rather have the money and be able to spend it themselves rather than have us send things over. And I think we've pretty well learned that.